may have a chance to win a GAF camera, among other exciting prizes. Stay home and win. And here, in person with us tonight, the man we all love and adore. He'll keep you grinning and winning all night. The man with nonstop energy and enthusiasm, Mr. Ken Friedman.
Hey! Hey! Woo! You know, another Tuesday night. What the hell are you going to do? It's cold now, so I thought I'd drop in. You know what I mean? Welcome to 23rd Street, the derelict capital of the world, for another big giveaway. Dean is back from south of the border. How are you? So nice to see you. Let's begin our show by thanking our telephone for all its hard work in the past few months. It's in for a series. Let's bring out our fabulous giveaway lady. She's live, she's loose, she's limber. The one, the only Miss Carrie Klein. Carrie, come on out. Wait, I think the fans are cheering.
I bring my live audience with me wherever
that
I
was very, very effective. Thank you all for our studio audience for your standing ovation.
Yes, and
wait for your fan. Say hi, fan.
My one fan.
Say goodbye to your fan. We have a
Stay
big
there.
Show tonight. So pay no attention to what's going on. We have a wonderful show. I don't know when it's going to begin. Perhaps shortly. We have questions. We have answers. We have prizes. We have lots of things. We have a sick crew. We have anything we can take. The bunny. Pardon me. I want to put this down. Okay. The first question. It's really a dumb question, I'm sure. Some of you people will have dumb answers. What the heck? You know, it's Tuesday. We're getting near Christmas. We're a little depressed. The oven's lit. I'm ready to go any minute now. The first question. Yes, it is. The first question. Worth a prize. Jerry Lewis. I never heard of him. That's the answer. Jerry Lewis has put together a new version of Hell's a Poppin'. That's right. For the Broadway stage. What other stage? The Broadway stage. Who starred in the original version, the original movie version? It was also a Broadway show, by the way. Years ago, before it was a movie. They didn't know that. Hell's a Poppin'. Who are the stars of the original Hell's a Poppin'? You're wrong.
Good evening. How are you? Ken Friedman here, Big Giveaway's charming host.
Hi.
And who are you?
Karen.
Karen, so nice to hear from you. Do you know who the original stars?
Yes, Olsen and Johnson.
You're right, Karen. Now, what were their first names?
That I don't know.
Okay, that's close enough. What were the names of their wives and children?
I'm not sure.
She's not sure. That's right. That's what the names are. Swedish is, I'm not sure, was one, and that's not certain is the other. And here to tell you what you've won, this show is off to a fabulous flying start as we get into our Christmas spirit. The lovely Carrie Charisma Klein to tell you, Karen, what you've won out there. So stay on the phone, hey!
Okay, you've just won an Herbal Essence gift set. Experience the delightfully fresh fragrance of herbs and wildflowers in Clairol's Herbal Essence Shampoo and Herbal Essence Bath Trio, a luxurious bubble bath, body powder, and body splash.
Hey, do you wash your hair?
Terrific, and I use that shampoo.
Well, now you can wash your hair more than once.
Have
friends over. Have a washing the hair party.
Great.
That's fantastic, Karen. So hold on. Hold on to the phone, rather. Don't hang up. I don't want to get personal because who knows what you're into. And our young lady at the other end of the line will take your phone number. Beg pardon? Depends what I'm into. Well, call me after the show, Karen. Goodbye. Thanks for playing. I'm really glad you won.
Thank you.
Bye.
Isn't that nice? Now, the number to call is 955-9987. Excuse me, I lost my script. Those things happen. The number to call is 955-9987. 955-9987. Out of town, don't bother, because we do not call, collect, accept collect calls. Phil, how are you in the booth? Here's the number to call. If you're not interested, who cares? I'll save this for later on in the show. Don't stare at me that way, you know. I have a lot of problems. Oh, wait a minute. It's our contest, folks. This is terrific. Four fabulous prizes worth at least $3. They're available to you, our fabulous viewers out there. All you have to do after the show is call us at, what's the number? The number is 955-9987, 955-9987, area code 212. Call us after the show. Merely give us your phone number. We'll have a drawing. If we pick your number out, you will win the following fabuloso prizes as attested to by the dynamic Miss Carrie Klein. Thank you. You're beautiful.
From the Needlework Store, a natural finish wooden wall cabinet with two shelves and a drawer designed to display your favorite needlepoint. That's from the Needlework Store, specializing in 100% wool knitting and crochet yarns. If you have a wood-burning stove or fireplace, why not burn the real thing? Blazing Bundles is a real firewood company servicing Manhattan customers with cordwood, stovewood, kindling, or convenient bundles delivered right to your home. Shop around, but before you buy, check our prices by calling 877-7000. That's 877-7000. From the Clean Scene, a free apartment cleaning or free help for your holiday party. That's the Clean Scene. Call the new number 877-8360. That's 877-8360. The GAF 2020's compactable pocket camera features a built-in electronic flash for big, colorful pictures indoors or in low light. The camera body contracts to fit pockets and expands for use. The exciting new compactable camera from GAF. Ken?
Because of you, the sun will shine. The moon and... Oh, are we on? Oh, excuse me. I'm just revving up for the third... That's a really terrific contest, whatever those prizes are. If you have room in the house, call us after the show, 955-9987. Question number two, a fabulous question, a real tough question. So think about it, folks, and smile and dial and win a pile. Copies of that poem are available after the show. $5 a piece for two, $20 for none. Thank you. What country did Russia invade in 1939? That's rather personal. Maybe they don't, you know, it could be a secret. What country did Russia invade in 1939? Specifically, well, that makes it easy. November 30th, 1939. That should give it away. Hello, big giveaway. I'm Ken Friedman. Who are you, sir?
I'm Marlene.
Marlene, I made a mistake.
Terrible.
What's terrible?
That you called me sir.
Well, I just took a wild guess. It's been that... No, it's a rash assumption on my part. I've heard stories about you, but I'm not going to get into that, Marlene.
Okay.
It's your... I'm not into my stories either. I'm not going to get into you either, Marlene. So why not just stay friends? You're very sweet. Thanks for calling. Do you happen to know, by the way, what country Russia invaded?
I'll take a guess.
Good.
Poland?
Oh, close, but not quite, no.
Okay,
thanks for playing. I'm sorry you didn't get it right. Bye. Now she's mad at me, and I said, hello, big giveaway. Hi, how are you? Who is this, Marlene?
No, this is Phil.
Hiya, Phil. How you doing? Do you happen to know, Phil, the answer? What country did Russia invade 1939?
Would you believe Finland?
I would believe it, Phil, because you got it right. Dookie, Finland is the country. That's right. They invaded in 1939, and they got along great. They certainly did. And have you played the game before, Phil?
I certainly have.
And you've won again. Here's our lovely giveaway lady. She's sitting right over there waiting to tell you your prize. Phil, what's your last name, Phil? Phil Foreman, you're right, Phil. Thank you, Foreman.
Okay, Foreman, you've just won a Verdant lighting fixture designed and crafted to enhance your home and lifestyle. Beauty, quality, and distinction furnished by Verdant, the brightest name in lights.
Oh,
it's all yours, Ken.
Phil, it's yours. A fabulous light bulb. It's a shining prize. Now, do you have ceilings in your house or walls?
Certainly.
Well, now, here's your chance to get some light into your life, Phil. Just put it right in there to build it yourself. Wait till you see this prize. Do you have screwdrivers and wrenches and hammers?
No, but my wife does.
Great, okay, I'm glad you won. Thanks, have a Merry Christmas. Thanks for calling and playing the game. Goodbye and good luck.
That was Phil, folks. That was Phil Foreman. He's having a party. Everyone's invited who's watching the show over to Phil's house after the show. Now we have, look, folks, look at our wall. Our wall is barren. We've been announcing a fabulous graffiti contest for the past couple of weeks. Just send in your favorite graffiti. So far, we had a few entries. None of them we are able to read out loud over the air. So please, there's no prize involved yet. We may have a prize if we finally get one that we can use. So just send all your graffiti to us. Just find it wherever it's written. Send it to us. There it is. That's not graffiti, folks. That's the address of the show. That's the big giveaway care of Shamus Productions. Shamus spelled backwards is Samhas. 79 Madison Avenue, room 1012. Room 1012, New York, New York, 10016. So get all that filth and misery and rottenness out of your system. Send us your graffiti, and we'll put it up on the wall, and you'll be immortal. On a subway, which is where most of you belong, of course, which is where I am. So who's talking? Sports and current events in sports. I hope you know your sports, because this is a tough question. If you know your sports, it's rather simple. It's the only one that I knew. Who won the Heisman Trophy this year? That's not last year, not next year, but this year for the outstanding play in college. Well, the outstanding play in college football is Night of the Iguana. Outstanding play in college football. Who was the guy who was an outstanding play? His name is not... Good evening. How are you?
Okay, how are you, Ken?
I'm fine, thank you. Who is this?
This is Norm.
Hiya, Norm. Do you happen to know who won the Heisman Trophy this year?
I sure do. It's Dorsett from Pitt.
You got it. Dorsett from Pitt. Pitt from Dorsett. Your man knows his Dorsett from his Pitt. I want to give you a lot of credit for that, but thank you for playing again. There's no prize for that answer.
No prize?
But now, here's a prize.
Okay.
The lovely Carrie Klein, who is herself a prize. Just looking at this lovely creature. Here is the prize, Carrie. Good night.
Good night.
No, this is it.
Baby. Oh.
Courtesy of Mercury Records, we have Charles Erland and Odyssey, one.
Charles Erland and your Odyssey.
Jerry Lee Lewis, Country Class, two.
Do you like classical music?
Confunction.
Good.
Terry Bradshaw, I'm So Lonely I Could Cry, and the Ohio Players, Gold. Five
That's
albums,
right.
Courtesy of Mercury
Records.
Why don't
you just leave one
here with me? Oh, yeah, I'll just leave
Take
one here
with
you.
Take those over there.
Well, Norm?
Can I interest you in some albums?
Yeah, look, I'll make it. Look, these are all best-selling albums. They've sold a total of four or five each around the country. Do you have a phonograph?
Would you like to buy one? I need a gramophone for that.
Okay, gramophone is right. Thanks for playing the game. I'm sorry you didn't get something you liked, but that's what life is, you know. Every day the sun can shine, if you know what I mean. Makes a better person out of you. Builds character. Your family will be proud if you're playing the game.
Right.
Bye. Thanks for playing the game. Bye-bye. Everybody calls. Everybody's right.
We have only one wrong answer so far. Aha! Christmas. We had another big thing last week. We had a big hour. I want a gift at Christmas kit. That's what it was. It's a fabulous kit that we sell to you for $400. It's guaranteed to get you gifts at Christmas. Now, don't question it. Just accept it on face value. What it is a big sign. You get a big sign that goes up on your door, and it says, United States Post Office. That's for you folks who don't get much attention to Christmas. You put that sign. Don't ask what it means. Don't question its magic powers. You put your sign at the United States Post Office, and just sit back and wait. Folks will start coming to you with fabulous gifts. Here's an example. Here's my piece. Now, on the front of each gift, don't look for your name. They're too modest. They'll have the names of the people who contributed to buying you this fabulous gift. And then exchange this warm Christmas greeting. Says, how much, where to, and when will it get there? Then you take this as a little procedure. You shake it, and you throw it into a bin. That's right. They'll smile. They'll leave. You rush over. You open it up. You've got your fabulous Christmas gift. They've got nothing. And that's the way you want it to be. So if you want this, just send us $400 or any part thereof to... That's it, the address. Okay, boys, wake up, fellas. I know that he dropped it. Don't pick on the guy, he has a cold. He's not feeling well, he's got a cold. There it is, the big giveaway, care of Shalman Productions, 79 Madison Avenue, that's our downtown office. The other one's our uptown office, our downtown office, the big giveaway, Shalman Productions, no one's gonna send us any money anyway, so who needs a graphic when you're tired? Okay, that's it. So pay attention to that one, folks. Question number four, worth a fabulous prize, maybe. Everything good, okay. What is the only word the raven says in Edgar Allan Poe's The Raven? He says, what's for lunch? You know that. I know that also. What does the raven say? He says, I'm not a raven. That's what he says. And you are. I'm Ken. Are you a raven?
I'm Joel.
Joel, how are you, Joel? You got through.
Yeah.
What did the raven say? He said, you savage, you. I love you.
Nevermore.
Nevermore. Quoth the raven, nevermore. And for no... Now, okay. What was the raven's name?
Irving.
It's a two-part question. What?
Irving
is right. What was the name of Irving's daughter?
Cindy.
Cindy is totally correct. No prize.
Here's Terry Klein, our fabulous giveaway lady, to tell you what you've won.
What's your name?
Joel.
You ever heard of Joel?
Four prizes. Bring them out for Joel. Who cares?
Okay, Joel, two tickets to see the Opie Award winner David Mamet's Sexual Perversity in Chicago and Duck Variations, both at the Cherry Lane Theater this Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock. These tickets are courtesy of the Cherry Lane Theater located at 38 Commerce Street, a beautiful neighborhood. Plus, you've also won dinner for two at New York's only no-nonsense restaurant. Good food, good wine, good company. Who would want more? Leon's Coffee House, 585 2nd Avenue.
Oh, that's a great place. Leon's Coffee House at 2nd Avenue and 32nd Street. The food's terrific. The people are very nice.
And you can do both. You go there for dinner.
How do I get there?
Where do you live?
Uptown.
You live uptown? Well, forget the whole thing. No, I forget the whole thing. I just try and sell the gift. Where do you live uptown? Take a bus downtown. And then you find 32nd and 2nd. You walk and say, hello, Leon, I want to eat. Yeah, you eat your heart out, whatever. Then you go from there, you go back to the west side. You go and see the two shows. And then that's
it's a whole
it.
Night out.
It's a great night out. Have a nice time. Thanks for playing the game. Merry Christmas.
Goodbye. What? Yeah, and they'll take your name and phone number and address. Okay. Thank you. Bye. Okay, now we have fabulous, another Christmas offer. Here it is. An album is called Adolf Hitler's Greatest Christmas Hits. Adolf Hitler sings Christmas favorites. That's right. You hear such songs as I'm Dreaming of a World Conquest. The Taste of Jingle Bells on the First Day of Christmas. My True Love Gave to Me. Poland, yes, right. Strike Up the Bund. London Bridge is Falling Down. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Hess. You've Got to Have Hate. And that's right, all available on this fabulous, schmabulous album, which will explode when thrown from a movie car. Yes, right, oh, the one he made popular, Czechoslovakians Roasting on an Open Fire. That's right, Adolf Hitler, his big album that sold 3 or 4 copies. Call us in after the show. Also, hi, the gang's all here. That's right, Adolf sings his Christmas favorites. Adolf Hitler, the man who put the X back into Christmas. Here it is, his album. Please, let's calm down. We're all adults. This is a public place. People come in, they use the train. This is a reality, folks. 9 months here, not one train, right? What enthusiasm. All right, that's enough of that. Now we come to nostalgia. Now we come to perhaps the highlight of our show. Folks, how long has it been since you listened to the radio? Huh? Maybe when you drive a car, but not like in the old days. Some of you may even know what a radio is, right? It's a little thing with little knobs on front. Not your wife. It's a little thing you put on the refrigerator. That's what it is, folks. Radio. And if you'll watch closely now, through the magic of our wonderful producer, Mr. Arnie Rosenthal, we are going to give you a radio show. So watch us closely, and the big giveaway goes right on radio. How about now? Radio. Yes, now we're on
radio. All right, just have a seat right here. Do you know what size you wear?
Well, I can wear 8, but my feet feel better in 9.
But 11's fitting better. Well, I'll take off this shoe and see what size it is.
Pull that off easy, will you, mister? That little toe mine.
All right, now, this is radio, folks. Now, watch closely. You're watching radio. Tell your friends to come in and watch radio. And can you name that program, that great old program? Hello, big giveaway, Ken Friedman. Are you watching the radio?
No, I'm watching the television.
No, what's on, though?
Nothing.
That's right, that's us. That's our show, the big giveaway, the big nothing show on radio or TV. Now, use your imagination. Try to picture what I look at. Forget what you know. Get a crayon and draw my face on your radio. What was the name of that show, sir? You're totally wrong. Now, you're right. I wanted to do more of this because I love being on radio. Look at the mystery it adds. And look at the excitement. Use your imagination. You don't have to strain your eyes. Okay, we're back now. That's it. You got the question right.
Thank you.
He ruined our evening. What's your name, sir?
Neil.
Neil, you son of a gun. You got it right. Okay, can we have that thing back? We're not going to have the thing back ever.
Oh, you look bad at
that. I look much better this way. Let's have the fabulous Kerry Klein to tell you what you've won. Neil. Tell Neil what he's won.
Neil has won 2 tickets to see the Greenwich Village Follies. Ronnie Britton is to the 70s, but Florence Ziegfeld was to the 20s and 30s. Mr. Britton has written the music and lyrics to the hottest and naughtiest show in town. The Greenwich Village Follies is now in its 5th smash month, the Gate Theater on 2nd Avenue and 10th Street. A musical review with 25 songs, a nude ballet, and 10 glorious men and women. Performances are Wednesday through Sunday evenings. Call 533-8010. Take a bite of the Big Apple. Go and see Ronnie Britton's Greenwich Village Follies.
That commercial is longer than the show, by the way.
Is that you that I saw in the picture?
Yeah, that's me with the blonde wig. I'm the girl in the middle. That's what makeup can do for you, and that's what acting is.
Oh.
But I'll tell you about that in another show. Well, Neil, I'm glad you won.
Thank you.
Enjoy the show, and don't call us ever again, Neil.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Thanks for playing. Okay, we're moving right along to the breakneck pace. It's just fabulous. Don't forget our graffiti contest. Our wall needs you. Here it is, question number 6. Question number 6. In the Dick Van Dyke Show, or the Dick Van Dyke Show, what was the name of the TV show that Rob Petrie on that show wrote for a show. What was the name of the show? No one's going to get this. The host of that show was played by Carl Reiner. Be quiet. You know the answer. Who cares? Show off.
Good evening, big giveaway.
After 20 minutes waiting, you have to give me
That's a tough one. That's the toughest question of the night. You wouldn't know an answer. Well, Santa, I'll tell you, I'm sorry you didn't know it. But play next week, and perhaps you'll know something next week.
Well, maybe you'll ask something unknowing.
I'm sorry, man. I really am. I mean, my heart's broken. I feel for you. But what can you help it? Look, you make a question, you make an answer. It's a show. It's a cheap show.
Well,
you do what you can. Give my regards to the wife, to the family in college. Maybe they'll have a Christmas. Goodbye and good luck. Bye. Good evening. Big giveaway.
Yes, the Mel Davis show?
The Mel Davis show is so wrong. What a bad guess. Thanks for playing. Goodbye. Hello. Big giveaway. Who is this? I'm fine. I'm very well. Thank you. Who is this?
This is Norman.
Did you just call Norman?
No, that's a different Norman.
Every week it's the same thing. We get 2 different... Norman, it's abnormal to get 2 different Normans on a normal night.
Well,
Norman, do you happen to know?
I think it's the Alan Brady Show.
I don't believe that you got it, man, because I never even heard of the first show. I never heard of Dick Van Dyke. And you are a brilliant guy to get this answer. Now, the part 2 of the question is, what did Alan Brady look like?
He looked very much like Carl Reiner with Adam.
Very good. He looked just like Carl Reiner because he was Carl Reiner. Thank you. You're beautiful. And here's the lovely Kerry Klein to tell you, Norman, what you've won for playing the big giveaway. Tell your friends to watch the show and win cheap prizes. Thank you. Hold on.
Cheap prizes is a great prize. This is courtesy of A&M. 2 prizes. Courtesy of A&M Records, The Carpenter's Horizon. This is El Chicano, 2. Herb Alpert, Just You and Me.
Herb Alpert, Just You
Andre Castellanos plays A Chorus Line and Chicago. And plus, that's 4 albums. Now you have a plus. You've also won 2 tickets to the New York Experience, the amazing film spectacle of sight, sound, and sensation, now in its 4th year at the Translux Experience Theater, 49th Street and 6th Avenue. There you go.
Wow, that's all right. I want to tell you, this guy really hit the jackpot.
Norm, you son of a gun, you.
Yes,
it's going to be a merry, merry Christmas in your household.
Happy Hanukkah to you, too.
Thank you very much, and the best to all your friends and family, wherever they are. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye, Norman. Hold on, and all that.
God, it's nice. It's really nice to have a winner out there, you know. It kind of, that's what we're here for, really, folks. We're here to have winners. We're here to, I'm terribly sorry. I put my hand in the flowers. Those things happen to the bees. We're moving on now to question number 7. Before that, a quick, brief commercial. We know Christmas is here. You folks may be tired of cooking. You're in a hurry. You got to go buy your gifts. You know, you got to go exchange your gifts. You got to go pickpocket in crowds. You got to keep busy, right? Don't sneeze in the middle of the thing. Please don't sneeze because it'll be, sneeze. Get it over with. It's a subway. You can do anything you want. You gotta walk, you know, where you walk. We have for you the fabulous, here it is. Get a close-up of this. This is Swanson's, a new product on the it's on the market. It's Swanson's TV Frozen Leftovers. That's right. Swanson's TV Frozen Leftovers. It's fantastic. You get things in here. You get leftover. You get leftover bones. You get a frozen napkin, a frozen thing here to wrap your hands in. You get a frozen, slightly eaten dessert. It's all yours. It's fabulous. You get even, delicious. The fourth time around, it tastes so much better. You get the fabulous frozen belch to show that you're satisfied. And that's not all that Swanson's have to offer. Right here, I'm holding right now in my hands, and you look closely, you see it. It's the Swanson's, I'll get it straight, Swanson's TV Frozen Fast. That's right. Here it is, a Swanson's TV Frozen Fast. It's nothing. That's right. Now, this year, we're selling it for $3. Last year, we know it cost $2.50, but everything is going up. Nothing is the same, as they say, or nothing is not the same. It's a Swanson's TV Frozen Fast. Let me put it down. Or the Swanson's TV Frozen Leftovers. The entire kit is yours for $18.95. Call us after the show and say, I'm dumb, and we'll send you everything, because we don't care anymore. Thank you. You're beautiful. Question number 7 is, the pace is fantastic. Pictured here, not here, there. There is. Pictured here is a man with a severe lip problem. The poor guy, when he gets his tongue straightened out. That's his sex life. I don't want to show that kind of picture again. This is not X-rated, folks. That's it. What is his name? What is that musician's name? His fans or the musicians called him the bird. Not to his face. But they called behind, they called Mark Fidrich is incorrect. I'll try this person right here.
Hello, big giveaway, and merry, merry, merry Christmas. I'm Ken Friedman, the Santa Claus of the airwaves. Yes, I know, we're way ahead of time. Do you happen to know the answer, sir?
No.
You don't know the answer. Take a wild guess.
The stork? You called him the bird.
We called him the bird, and you think it's a stork?
It's Hendrix. He plays right
Jimi
here.
Hendrix. Right. Thanks for being wrong, because we need some wrong answers, and thanks for cooperating. You're beautiful. Call next week, will you?
No.
Hello, small giveaway. You don't know. Thank you for calling, don't be ashamed. We all make mistakes. Your life is full of mistakes, so what's one more in public? Goodbye. Hello, true. Hi, how are you? I'm Ken Friedman, jovial host of the fabulous big giveaway. The show with no ratings. Do you know who played the saxophone?
No way.
No way. I thought everybody would.
Huh?
Okay, thanks for playing. Bye. Great. No one knows. That's what we need, a tough question, because we have a lot of time. Hello. Good evening. Is this a man or a woman?
This is a man.
You're right!
Thank you.
You're right. Great. Now, what's your name?
My name's Alan.
How it worked out for you, Alan. The same sex, a masculine name. Your parents were sharp. When they weren't confused, they went right in and they said, man, give him a masculine name.
Right,
I hope everything has worked out well for you from that point on. You had a big head start on me, for instance. All right, now, do you know the guy whose picture was up there eating his saxophone?
Yes, I do.
You know that? I'm hanging up, because I don't want any right answers. I get 6 minutes. I want some wrong answers. Hang up on him. I won't do that. Do you happen to know his name?
Yes, his name is Charlie Parker.
You're absolutely right, Alan. I'm not going to fool around with you. I gave you a hard time. But you hung in there, you showed class, you showed dignity, in spite of my heavy razzing. Where's the gong, Klung? We still have 5 minutes, but don't worry about it, because here's a very slow Carrie Klein to repeat 4 or 5 times what you've won. Hang on, Alan.
Okay, for the one who identified Charlie Parker, you've won a bit of music. 2 tickets to see Dan Hill at the other end this weekend. The other end for good fun, good sound. The other end is located at 149 Bleecker Street in the Village.
That's it? No, can't stretch it? Do you ride a night, Alan?
Well, that's a great place.
It's terrific.
That's a really nice night.
It's terrific.
Yeah, it's a great place. You have a girlfriend or a boy, whatever you have, it doesn't matter, a pet dog, a flea. Bring them along, have a great evening there on us, on them, actually. And thanks for playing. Do you watch the show all the time?
I missed you last week, Ken. What did you say?
Oh, last week was a winner. We had Name That Mountain last week. Oh, that was terrific. I had the whole studio covered with Mountain. Well, maybe we'll do it again sometime.
Okay.
Thanks for playing the game, Alan, really.
Okay.
Bye.
See how nice and polite I can be. I'm really a great guy when I'm on television at home and something else. Now it's time to repeat the 4 fabulous prizes that we offer to you, our great public out there. Right, you know who I mean. I mean you, yes. Our fabulous contest of 4 terrific prizes, which you can win merely by calling us after the show or by breaking in here about 2 o'clock in the morning. So here she is, the great Carrie Klein, to tell you what you may win while I sing to myself in the mirror. Because that's the kind of guy I am.
From the Needlework Store,
a
natural
needlework
finish wooden wall cabinet with 2 shelves and a drawer designed to display your favorite needlepoint. That's from the Needlework Store, specializing in 100% wool knitting and crochet yarns. If you have a wood-burning stove or fireplace, why not burn the real thing? Blazing Bundles is a real firewood company servicing Manhattan customers with cordwood, stove wood, kindling, or convenient bundles delivered right to your home. Shop around, but before you buy, check our prices by calling 877-7000. That's 877-7000. Woo! From the Clean Scene, a free apartment cleaning or free help. help for your holiday party. That's the clean scene. Call the new number, 877-8360. That's 877-8360, and speeding right along. The GAF 2020's compactable pocket camera features a built-in electronic flash for big, colorful pictures indoors or in low light. The camera body contracts to fit pockets and expands for use. The exciting new compactable camera from GAF.
I've got you here in the heart of me. Excuse me. I didn't know. I was just talking to my close friend. The last question of the night, and I hope you have no answers, because we have no prizes. What? This is a tough question. You'll never get this. Why even ask it? What happened to U.S. paper money in 1929? What happened in 1920? You're right. What happened in 1929 to U.S. a $3 bill? Thank you, you're beautiful. What happened to U.S. paper money in the year 1929? Good evening. How are you? That's all right. That was my close friend of mine. What do you want, sir? Hello? Hello, anybody there? Hello?
Hello?
Hi. Do you know what happened to U.S. paper money in 1929?
It went off the gold standard.
No, that's not correct. Something happened to it physically.
Oh, it got smaller. I thought you meant the...
That's true. It did. It got smaller, and you are totally correct. Now, what's your name, sir?
It's Neil again.
Neil again. And here is the lovely Carrie Klein to tell you what you've won.
This is Neil again?
Yes, sir.
$90 worth of Zebrick decorative wall covering. Add character and charm to your walls and create a whole new living atmosphere. Zebrick, the last word in wall covering. Plus, you've also won two tickets to see the Obie Award winner, David Mamet's Sexual Perversity in Chicago, and Duck Variations, both at the Cherry Lane Theater this Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock. These tickets are courtesy of the Cherry Lane Theater, sorry Ken, located at 38 Commerce Street.
All right. Hello, how are you?
Okay.
Yeah, that's a nice. Have you seen the show?
Oh, yeah, I saw the whole thing. I always watch it. It's great. I love it.
No, I mean that show, Duck Variations.
Oh, the Chicago.
Yeah, it's really good.
Oh, I'll have
You'll enjoy it. It's very, very well written. It's going to be going closing soon, I think, so hurry up and get down there.
Okay.
Okay, tell your friends to go and see Duck Variations, etc., etc. It stars Hyde Dolinsky, by the way. Hyde Dolinsky and Phyllis Blackman are the stars of that show. I pressed hold. I put him on. Now
that we're off the air,
the number to call is nothing. Don't call us at all. Or after the show, the contest, call us at 955, come on, Terry, tell us, 955-9987, 955-9987, and out of town, call yourself.
We're going to try what we didn't do very well last week.
Oh, yes. Right.
Let's get it right this time.
I want you all to sing with us. It's a sing-along. I want you to join us.
You have to clap your hands with this.
Dashing through the snow on a one-horse open sleigh. For the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring.
Okay. We have to say goodnight.
We know what we mean.
This is Tuesday night. Next Tuesday night, we'll be here.